DC.com to stream live. When bureaucrats in DC can't answer yes or no to a question, it means they're hiding something. Yeah. Here's CPB commission nominee Chris Magnus asked simply if there's a crisis on the border.
Mr. Magnus, I'd like to start off with a yes or no question. You believe we have a
crisis? You know what's going to happen.
Crisis at the southern border, yes or no?
Senator, I...
That's not yes or no.
I'm not sure. Does it really matter whether we call it a major challenge, a crisis, a big problem? I
think it speaks to a level of urgency and seriousness of purpose and an understanding of the gravity of the situation. I mean,
and why are you so afraid of the word? Why is everybody in the Democrat Party afraid of the word?
Presumably, one would answer the call to serve in this position because you understand the importance at this moment in history of being commissioner of CBP. So
this commission is actually becoming a crisis.
We have a crisis at the border. Yes or no?
Senator, let me assure you that no one believes there is greater urgency to this matter than I do.
You know, if my kid asked me yes or no, could I have a candy bar? I would just say yes or no. If I was in Washington, D.C., I'd say, you know, candy is an interesting concept, something I've been studying. You know, just say yes or no. You may have noticed that America has gone off the rails in a lot of ways. Former New York Times reporter Barry Weiss explained that to a clueless Brian Stelter.
You're right. There are tens of millions of Americans who aren't on the hard left or the hard right who feel the world has gone mad. So in what ways has the world gone mad?
Here we go.
Well, you know, when you have the chief reporter on the beat of COVID for the New York Times talking about how questioning or pursuing the question of the lab leak is racist, the world has gone mad. When you're not able to say out loud and in public that there are differences between men and women, the world has gone mad.
When
we're not allowed to acknowledge that rioting is rioting and it is bad, and that silence is not violence, but violence is violence, the world has gone mad.
Yeah, that's good.
When we're not able to say that Hunter Biden's laptop is a story worth pursuing, the world has gone mad.
When you can't say that Brian Stelter looks a lot like Humpty Dumpty, the world has gone mad.
When, in the name of progress, young school children, as young as kindergarten, are being separated in public schools because of their race, and that is called progress rather than segregation, the world has gone mad.
Pretty nutty.
There are dozens of examples that I could share.
Then she explained that CNN is actually part of the problem.
You say we're not allowed, we're not able. Who's the people stopping the conversation? Who are they?
People that work at networks, frankly, like the one I'm speaking on right now.
Yeah, like you, doofy.
Try and claim that, you know, it was racist to investigate the lab leak theory. It was.
I mean, who let's said just that take at CNN? Example. But I'm just saying that when you say allowed, I just think it's a provocative thing to say. You say we're not allowed to talk about these things, but they're all over the internet. I can Google them.
Brian,
I can find them everywhere.
No, they're actually censored all over the internet, the mainstream media, big social media, and the Democrat Party.
Where I've heard about every story you mentioned.
Of course.
So I'm just suggesting, of course, people are allowed to cover whatever they want to cover.
But you and I both know, and it would be delusional to claim otherwise.
The insufferable Kamala Harris recorded a video to only be shown in black churches in Virginia. That's not racist at all. Yeah. Endorsing Terry McAuliffe for Virginia governor. Oh, yeah. This is illegal.
Greetings, everyone. So when I was growing up, we sang in the choir at Oakland's 23rd Avenue Church.
How is your husband, the Joker, doing?
Of God. We sang hymns about how faith combined with determination.
Yeah, she lived in Berkeley, not exactly, you know, down with the struggle.
Will see us through difficult times. And we were taught that it was our sacred responsibility to raise our voice and lift up the voices of our community. One of the most significant ways I believe that we can each use our voice is through our vote. So Virginians, you have the opportunity now to raise your voice through your vote.
Yeah, that's electioneering and it's illegal.
Because it's election time. I believe that my friend Terry McAuliffe is the leader Virginia needs at this moment.
As you know, millions of Americans are chanting bleep Joe Biden at sporting events and clubs. Here's a sample put together by Sky News Australia. You know you've lost when you've lost the line dancers.
Joe Biden!
We need more cowbell. I've got a fever, and the only cure is a little more cowbell. Now, the obscene phrase is also the theme of iTunes' number one hip-hop song. Call any songs or chants like this about Donald Trump. It's got a nice beat and it's fun to dance to. Coming up.
So you asked
Chicago Mayor Lori Lightfoot calls those who protect and serve insurrectionists. Stick around.